7:50, Corey Keeley, food stylist, specialist, and genius in my world, is with us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, so we're excited because these are finally here.
The blueberries.
Bad boys.
The berries are all out. You can still get the raspberries. You can still sometimes get strawberries. They're delicious. They're more flavorful than you can ever imagine.
Yeah, that's a thing.
Every year it's a surprise. I think, this is what we wait for.
Right.
So the blueberries are beautiful. So when I was thinking about ways to get my kids to eat more fruit, I don't really need to, but some people say, what do we do? So I made this recipe called fruit roll-ups. And so initially you think for sure candy, but this is using whole grain pizza dough.
Okay.
And then some of the fall harvest and the late summer harvest. So our blueberries, they're going to be around right up until September.
Okay.
You can throw apples in here. You can throw zucchini in here. So you can get green and spelt it. And the trick with zucchini and anything is to shred it up. It kind of disintegrates a little bit. You can't see it. The color looks beautiful.
I would never have guessed that that's zucchini, right?
Yeah. So, and when you bake it, you'll see. Well, can you see zucchini in those finished? No. So what we're going to do
There's zucchini in here?
Yeah.
All right, then.
So there you go.
So here's the thing. My little guy, I actually have to stop him from eating fruit. He's such a fruit freak. He's 3 years old, and he's just like blueberries. He'll give you a big smile, and it'll be all blue.
They're so good for you, though. Mm-hmm. And again, with all your berries, when you're purchasing them, you want to make sure that they're not bruised or damaged on the top. Have a look on the bottom if it's in, especially if it's in paper. If there's any stains on the bottom, it means it's crushed, perhaps, and so you want to avoid that
so
box.
So keeping an eye out for that.
Yeah, okay. They're best stored. Like I keep them on the counter with a little bit of a cloth over top of them.
Is that right?
You can put them into the fridge as well. Buy lots at this time of the year, and then you're just going to rinse them, pat them dry, put them in the freezer on a tray, get them so they're frozen, then throw them into a Ziploc bag or something for the winter so you've got that fresh
and
flavor.
And they're actually, they freeze really, really well.
They
right?
do. They freeze so well. Okay. They're perfect.
Let's
so,
get going
okay,
on this.
So our right. fruit roll-up. So we're going to take 8 ounces of cream cheese, zest, about a teaspoon of zest of lemon or lime, whichever, cinnamon, and a little bit of honey to sweeten. You're going to mix this up. And just you're gonna
I can
you're,
do that. If
you want. Okay. And then you're gonna spread it on here. It's okay. It's actually super easy.
Yeah. Are you sure it's easy?
Spread it out here like this.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna get the ingredients really nice.
So this is basically like a cinnamon roll.
But yeah.
Instead of using using like brown sugar and high sugar, you're gonna sweeten it with your fruit. So you just spread that all out evenly.
Okay.
Yep, see? And this is fun. When you're buying this frozen pizza dough, you can get it at a bakery. I got this at Parma Ravioli. Just check it out. Anywhere that's making pizza dough or baked goods like that.
So how thick? It just has to be enough
just
to bind whatever is being rolled?
It's gonna hold on to our zucchini. I'll start at the top. Okay. You work your way down. So you're going to take about, I guess this is probably about 2 cups
There's
of
way
zucchini.
More here than I thought. Wow, look at this. It really goes a long way.
It goes a long way. And the cinnamon adds a ton of flavor.
No kidding.
And you're going to put this in here. Yeah. I think you're good.
I'm doing okay.
Yeah. And then you're going to sprinkle your blueberries. And you would shred your apples if you were going to use apples in the fall. But I substituted with some strawberries because we could still find some beautiful Ontario strawberries.
Good idea.
Yeah. And so you can just have fun with it. But I think the zucchini is kind of the key to this because it is so fun to afterwards let your kids know they had a bunch of zucchini.
Yeah. By the way, suckers.
Another reason. Everyone's like, what do I do with zucchini? I'm like, shred it and put in everything.
Just I don't know. Grilling zucchini, in my opinion, is unbelievable anyway.
Oh,
but
it's
if the kids
so
won't eat it,
good.
Then this is good.
Yeah, my kids won't eat zucchini, but they do. They just don't know. It's like mushrooms. There's mushrooms in almost everything they eat. Who knew you could put mushrooms into baked goods? Just kidding.
That's right. Well, what's funny is they think they don't like it, and then later on in life, they can come around to that notion, right?
Well, you know what? It is true because they are probably developing a taste for it, whether they like it or not.
That's right.
Whether they know it or not. So basically, you're just rolling this up.
That was really easy. Now, was it actually easy, or is this
easy.
Your incredible talent?
No, it's that easy. The only thing that kind of is a pain, maybe, is rolling out the flour, but that's also super fun for kids. Like, this is an interactive thing. So you're going to cut this into even slices.
Okay.
Put on a baking sheet. Bake at 450 for 18 minutes. Mm-hmm. So I've got the oven going. So by our next segment, we're going to have some fun roll-ups ready for you to eat.
Oh, my goodness.
See how pretty that is?
That is really,
so
really
pretty. So easy.
And like,
you know, this could be breakfast. This is whole grains,
fruit,
a little teeny bit of cream cheese, not even very much. You know?
So you tell people you're having zucchini for breakfast. They'll be surprised, right?
We won't tell them.
This is, again, tell me what goes in the kind of spread.
Okay, so that's just softened cream cheese with cinnamon, lemon zest, and a teeny bit of honey.
So as compared to, let's say, a Cinnabon, calorie-wise and fat content-wise, we're way, way below.
Wow, yeah. Okay. And sugar, even more important, I find, is sugar. Sugar messes you up.
It does.
And white flour, too. So your Cinnabon is white flour. It's probably butter or margarine, and it's also sugar. So it messes up your blood sugars. You're hungry afterwards. You're mixed up.
You're talking a lot more and more, hearing more and more about that, about spiking your blood sugar and what it does to you, how you eat the rest of the day.
It does. So
keep that in mind. I don't ever have a problem with moderation and snacks. No problem with that.
No?
But I wouldn't sit and eat a box
love Cinnabon. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
Hello, there's a time and place for that, for sure. Not at breakfast, though. This is going to be a good breakfast
for
you.
So this goes
in. Pop it in. 450 for about 18 minutes. So when we start our next segment, this will be ready to roll.
Okay, cool.
And delicious.
And you can just keep an eye on it too. That'll help you out, right?
Yeah.
And so when you see it get, you know, something like that.
Yeah, they get golden on the bottom. And then when you pull them out, we're going to drizzle them with some honey, a little bit. And then, you know, that's it.
When we do that, actually, we'll be starting a new segment with corn as well. And this year, when you get your hands on it, this is the best corn. I love it.
Oh,
Ontario sweet corn, any of that corn that you see around is delicious. We're going to do what with it?
We're going to make a good spasso. So it's cold. You don't have to heat up your kitchen or anything.
Love it.
All good.
That's
lots of veggies.
The way.